Tonight I'm gonna do something different to have your undivided attention. It's my mission, listen. We gon' get it poppin' like we're supposed to do. Whole production's jumping off, I put it on for you. 6-inch heels on, check. The lipstick, check.
Hi, this is my first eyeshadow tutorial. And first you want to prime your eyelid with any type of primer. I use NYX or Too Faced. I'm using a eyeshadow base. I love NYX, 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 whatever you want to call them. I love their jumbo pencils and they come in a variety of colors. So because I'm going to be doing a Christmassy look, which yes, I know Christmas has passed, but this is what I did and I liked it, so I decided to put this one up anyways. I'm going to be using mostly Wet n Wild eyeshadows because they're very pigmented and they're affordable and they're easy to work with and they blend very well. So everything's pretty much pretty clear. You know, I'm just doing a little voiceover just for those sections where I want to reiterate certain things. Right here, I'm using my 120 palette green. It's just a matte green. And what you want to do is you want to fill in the outer third of your eye lid with that darker color. And you want to just blend that outer third area until it's pretty much even across. And then you want to blend it over into your crease. And I'm going to do that. There you go. So yeah, it's just, you know, taking just that little bit of color just to pull it over just so it's a smooth transition. Now I'm going to take just a little crease brush and I'm going to take a dark brown and I'm going to do just the outer V a little bit smaller than I did the green just to define the corner, just to give it a little more oomph. Now I'm taking a clean blending brush and I'm just blending it all out so it's a smooth transition. This is Pigment and I love their pigments. They're very, very bold. And I'm just going to pat that on top of my gold just so I could define the gold a little more. And I don't really work with pigments without already doing the eyeshadow because they're pretty messy. They can get very messy. So I usually only use them to put on top of something to make it stand out a little more. I'm going to fill in my tear ducts with that gold pigment. This is just a double-ended eyeliner that I got from Walmart. And I just like that green. That green is so pretty. So I'm going to put that on my line here. My underline. And I'm just really using it as a base for the eyeshadow. I missed a clip, but I actually dipped the brush into that dark green matte that I put in the corner. And I'm only using that on the outer third. I'm going to take this color, and I'm going to put it in the middle. That one right there. And I'm going to blend that one into the darker green in the middle of my lower lash line. And I actually blended it into the gold, too. This isn't the best black coal eyeliner, but it was just the one that I put my hands on. So I'm going to do my waterline with this one. And I'm also going to do my top waterline also just to define the depth just a little more. And if you ever do this, you'll notice that it makes a big difference when you outline your under waterline, your top waterline, geez. I'm just going to do a black, simple black eyeliner on my top lash line. And I mainly do this because I usually wear lashes with looks like this. And I want to make sure I draw a smooth line for me to put my lashes on. And then it just defines the look too. This is a little winged eyeliner. This mascara I use for my bottom lashes because it has very small bristles and it's perfect for the bottom lashes. So that's what I'm doing. I really don't have any, as you can tell, but I try and put as much mascara on them. So that's the finished look with my eyelashes and my bottom lashes, and that's pretty much the eyes. Not too hard, but very dramatic, very bold. So now we're gonna do the rest of the face. And I use this bronzer from Wet n Wild. It's a dark shade. I use that to contour the hollows of my cheeks. And you'll see right there. It's just basically to chisel the face a little more. Just to, you know, it kind of, in my opinion, it takes a few pounds off your face. The lighting in my bathroom was not the best either. That is a very, very, very red blush. But you can't really tell because I have, my lights are too bright. This is what I use to highlight, and it's so smooth, and it goes with any complexion. I love that stuff. And I just put that on the tops of my cheekbones. And you just follow your natural cheekbone shape. Yeah, I'm gonna have to get me some better lights. Once again, lighting is horrible because that's a very red, very, very red lip liner, but it doesn't look so red. I'm just going to line my lips because I'm using a red lipstick and I don't want it to run. You use a lip liner whenever you don't want your lipstick to run. Kind of try, it keeps it where it should be. This is a Wet n Wild matte red lipstick, which is extremely red, but once again, due to lighting, you can't really tell. It's very, very red. But the pictures, you can see how red it is at the end. And this lipstick, I have pretty much every color in their matte lipsticks, the Wet n Wild brand. And they're very, very smooth and soft, and they have a lot of moisture in them. This is a NYX NYX Mega Shine lip gloss, and this is really red too. It's really awesome. And it smells like cherry. And this is pretty much my look. And I'm going to put some pictures at the end so you can actually see the right colors and how it really looks. But thanks for watching!